A reminder that I have imposed a very high bar on any puns to be used in this story. The lead's Aaron McPike joins us now. That high bar applies to mainly me. You can do what you want to do.
Well, any way you cut it, Jake, it does seem that Anthony Weiner's on a roll. How'd I do, okay?
That's pretty good. Weiner on a roll. I like that.
I would think that was actually yours. But the combination of what some people say is a weak field and a well-staged rollout has really helped Anthony Weiner stage a bit of a comeback.
Good morning. How are you today? Good.
Political pundits, start your punchlines. Anthony Weiner is rising in the polls in this year's wide-open New York City mayoral race.
Well, listen,
it's quite the turnaround. Just 2 years ago, photos like these ricocheted around Twitter and ended Anthony Weiner's congressional career.
I had hoped to be able to continue the work that the citizens of my district elected me to do.
But it wasn't career-ending. Even in this resignation speech, there was a note of defiance.
Now I'll be looking for other ways to contribute my talents to make sure that we live up to that most New York and American of ideals.
And so began one of the quickest rehabilitations in American politics. In April, a contrite Weiner posed with his wife, Huma Abedin, on the cover of the New York Times Magazine.
We love this city, and no one will work harder to make it better than Anthony.
6 weeks later, he made a splash, reintroducing himself to voters in his second try for the office. So far in the campaign, Weiner's past transgressions haven't been much of an issue.
Look, I made some big mistakes, and I know I let a lot of people down, but I've also learned some tough lessons.
His wife has done more than stick by him. She's headlining a Women for Anthony fundraiser today. That support may help boost Weiner in holding off New York City Council Speaker Christine Quinn, who's hoping to become the first woman to run the Big Apple.
What I think this race is about is delivering for New Yorkers.
One poll even shows Weiner with an edge among female voters and with a 5-point advantage overall. But another shows a closer race, with Weiner tied with Quinn and a third candidate, Bill Thompson.
We're 75, 76 days out, and there's still a lot of unhappiness with this field.
Despite Weiner's steady climb back into the political arena, one good poll or two is a far cry from victory. The primary is still more than 2 months away. And if no candidate can muster 40% in the party primary, the top two vote-getters will face off in a runoff October 1st.
That's when, you know, the whole scandalous past really will be brought out and sort of politically litigated, so to speak. That's when it'll really be talked about in a very pointed way.
Now, what I think is interesting about this is, of course, Mark Sanford was sworn into Congress again just a month ago. Now, he obviously didn't use Jenny Sanford in his campaign because they divorced, but he also apologized right up front as he was announcing his campaign, just like Anthony Weiner did.
And they both just took question after question after question until people
just stopped
asking about it. One other thing about Weiner is that the worst thing that happens to him is he's kind of back. He loses, but he's still back in public life, and he's gone through the gauntlet, and now he can kind of do whatever he wants to do.
Yeah, of course, it's a very fluid race right now,
right.
So who knows who wins.
Aaron McPike, happy birthday.
Thanks.